there, it's Paul here and welcome along everyone. Quite a simple project this time. Wolf, or the Howling Wolf on a rock in the moonlight. Quite a simple project to cut out. As you said at the beginning, the rock was cut out of a piece of plain dope that I'd used on a previous project. The moon, the wolf were just 3.6mm ply, and I think the backers also 3.6 ply as well. Just sprayed the moon totally white, and the following day after it dried, just give it a light spray of black just to give it a little bit of a more realistic colour. But the wolf totally black. The rock I totally roughed up with my rotary tool just so it gives it a bit more of a texture, more like a rock, and then finish that off with my homemade ebonizing solution. Once I've got that all together, I could then decide what size I want the background, cut that out, and gave that a total spray of black first of all, and more white at the top so it's more like a starry sky, and possibly maybe misty or cloudy or something like that as well. So I just think it makes it look a bit more realistic rather than just being totally jet black. I decided to just finish it off with the frame to make it look a little better. Could have done it with oak, as I've got some oak about, but it would have been a lot more messing around cutting up. And I've got that length of pine there, and so it's just with the rotor, just shaped the outside, just beveled off the back, just so that the pitch would go in there nice and flat. The whole thing was glued in. But what I decided to do with the actual frame is, a while ago I bought these for something totally different, nothing to do with wood turning or the workshop. It's by Colours. They do this gloss varnish, and they do all sorts. I mean, this one's an oak. The really weird thing of this, I mean, if you notice it in the video, even when you mix it up, it looks like a really sort of like purpley blue. And when you paint it on, you can actually see that purpley blue, but as you thin it out and it dries off, it soon takes the colour on. I basically gave that a couple of coats, and obviously because it's pine, I found it really roughed up a lot, so I sanded it all down nice and smooth again, and then just gave a final coat over it just to finish it off. So if this is your first time here, I put up regular project videos most Wednesdays for the scroll saw, wood turning videos on the Sunday. But please do subscribe, click the little bell next to the subscribe button, and at least that way you'll get notified every time I upload a video. For my existing subscribers, again, as per usual, thank you very much for keep coming back. And I'd appreciate it if everybody could hit the share button, hit the like button, and please leave a comment below. Let me know what you think. So, thanks a lot for watching. Bye.